please stand for the presentation of colors posted by the Greensboro Fire Department Honor Guard and remain standing for the singing of the national anthem by Engineer Robert Johnson.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say doth that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you, and please take your seats. City Council members, Mr. Westmoreland, Chief Nugent, firefighters, police officers, family, and friends, good morning, and welcome to the graduation ceremonies of the 69th recruit class. My name is Brent Gerald. I am the Assistant Chief responsible for the Training Division. It is an honor to have you here with us today. I want to take a moment to recognize who is with us today. We have City Council members with us today. Would you please stand? Ms. Abuswader and Ms. Hoffman. Mr. Westmoreland, our City Manager. Chief Nugent and the Executive Team. We also have some VIPs here with us today. If you are a family member or a loved one of a recruit in this graduating class, please stand. The training staff and I would like to thank you. Without your support and care for the past 26 weeks, it would have been more difficult for your recruit to make it to this day. There's an exceptional group of people here I want to recognize. I'm going to call them by name and ask them to stand. Battalion Chief Brett Combs, Battalion Chief Brian Vickery, Captain Mike Brownell, Captain Kelly Giles, Captain Charles Hall, Captain Harold Haney, who is standing, you can't see him, he's in the back, and Captain Brian Jones. I consider this to be the best training staff in the country. They're dedicated, passionate about the fire service and this department. This group gives their all to ensure that each recruit is prepared to serve their community. They come in early, leave late. They lead by example. They try to live out our motto of work hard and be humble every day. Another important group to us and part of our training staff are our fitness instructors. Please stand. Mr. Walker, retired engineer, and Captain Sean Kennedy. Another member who's not present today is Engineer Kenny Robinson. They are a very important part of getting our people in shape and ready for this job. Also with us today are our police training staff. Please stand. These are our friends. We work with them every day. We build the bridge, they build the bridge, and we walk across it every day. So thank you for being with us today. And finally, but not least, Ms. Michelle Hebert is our program tech, facility manager. Everything keeps us in line. Thank you, Michelle. The process of becoming a firefighter for the 69th recruit class started more than a year ago. We received almost 800 applications, 334 scheduled to take the physical test, 198 passed the physical test to sit for the written test. We interviewed 100 and processed them and sat a class of 24. And today, 22 graduate. The training academy is unapologetically hard. It is designed to challenge you physically and mentally. With respect to a 30-year career, 26 weeks is a very short amount of time to instill principles in you that will last a lifetime. It is our hope that we have provided you with a solid foundation of which to build a career as a firefighter. It is our hope that you have developed a thirst for learning and improvement so that you can go out and make a difference every day. That's what this job is. You get to make a difference in the lives of others every day that you're on that truck. You have what I call a get-to career. You get to do things that others dream of. Sometimes you see things that no one else should see. But don't lose heart. Talk with someone. Seek the company of your coworkers and loved ones. And find a way to keep the passion and happiness that you are feeling right now. Today is about you, 69th, but this career that you have is not about you. Remember, this is what it's about. It's about those who allow us to serve, our families and our leaders. It's about those who we serve with, our brother and sister firefighters. And it's about those we serve, our neighbors and our community. Congratulations. And good luck in your career. Speaking of our community and this city, I invite Mr. Westmoreland up for a few remarks.
Thank you, Chief Gerald. Good morning, everybody. I'm Jim Westmoreland, the city manager here with Greensboro. It's a pleasure to be with you. I always enjoy these graduation ceremonies and the time that we're able to connect and bring you greetings from the city and City Hall. Again, as Chief Gerald said this morning, I did want to first recognize our two city council members along with the full city council members that are not here today. I can tell you, having been with the city now for close to 20 years, having been the city manager of the city now for 3.5 years, that our city council continues to support our fire department and our whole public safety team at a very high level. I think that we all know the importance of the job and the roles that you all are about to assume for the city, and we don't take it for granted. I think we were reminded again yesterday when we had a two-alarm fire at the North Elks Club, what important jobs you're about to assume, the things and circumstances that you'll be put into and situations that you'll have to handle that are important not only to the people that you're helping out and the issue that you're trying to resolve, but important to this community. So again, thank you to City Council and congratulations to you this morning. I did want to take just a couple of minutes to recognize, again, as the Chief mentioned, the members of the families who are here. I can tell you that as I look out across the audience, as all of you stood up to recognize and be recognized this morning for your loved ones and the role that they'll play with the fire department in the city, it hits home to me in thinking about some of the situations that I've experienced, again, since I've been with the city and seen the fire department and our public safety team have to deal with. I can tell you that your support here today, your continued love and support for these recruits going forward, soon to be firefighters going forward, is extremely important. They will need you more than ever, and I think these gentlemen and women of the fire department can attest to some of the situations that they'll be exposed to. But again, thank you for being here. So again, recruits, you will be put in some very difficult, challenging situations. I know that from the perspective of the training that you've received, you're well prepared to handle those situations. You also know that you've got the full support of this fire department team and family behind you. So I believe there's nothing that you can't tackle as it relates to this job and working with the city. Today, in addition to joining the fire department family and team, you'll also be joining a city team of over 3,000 employees. We work together as one city, one team. We focus on the core values of the city: stewardship, integrity, honesty, and respect. We focus on how we work together to solve problems, how we work together to provide services to this community. So I think that you'll find more support than you'll ever have received before in terms of the work and the focus of the team. And then finally, and you know this as well, you're about to join one of the finest, if not the finest, fire departments in the whole country. You're about to join one of the finest public safety support teams in the whole country. I can tell you that, again, you will find support. You will find help. You will become a member of an important team, both with the fire department and our public safety team, that's out there every day and every night responding to incidents, responding to situations that are beyond a lot of what other people have to experience from time to time. So again, thank you. Congratulations to you. And I'll leave you with this. Understand that every day when you come to work, there will be things that you'll face in your careers, both as fire department employees and with the city. Understand that you have an important role that you play in the organization in providing services to those in need. And understand that there will be times and situations where you'll need to rely upon others. So from the standpoint of both myself, the city management team, the fire department team and family, the public safety team and family, understand that we're with you. We're here to help support you in your efforts to become successful firefighters for the city of Greensboro. And again, thank you for the role that you've elected to play in our city organization. So thank you.
Good morning. I would like to echo a couple things that was said earlier, and thank you to the families for your hard work. You probably feel like you need to come across and get a badge as well. So I know it's hard work for you, and we appreciate that. And I also would like to echo what Chief Gerald said about our training staff. We do have the best training staff across the country. Every time we have our class and we start, we come in and we meet the folks and we talk to them, we recognize and tell them, you're being trained by some of the best that we have across this country. And so I would also like to recognize them as well, because they are the best that we've got. So we thank them as well. I have the privilege of presenting the Fire Chiefs Award. And before I do, just a few things I wanted to say. And you know I got to bring up the marshmallow test. And secondly, congratulations to the 7th recruit class that's sitting over to the side that gets to get a field trip today and gets to see how this thing works. So I hope this inspires you to continue on and work hard as your training progresses. So early on in the first days here, we came in, we talked to you, the staff came in, talked to you, kind of gave you some things that we're thinking about, some things that you can expect, and give you the support that you needed from the fire chief staff. And I talked to you a little bit about the marshmallow test. And my training staff guys, this is kind of silly stuff, they don't want to talk about it. But if you think about it, as silly as it may be, when we talked about the marshmallow test, if you recall in the very beginning, we're not talking about marshmallows at a literal sense. We're talking about things like going out to dinner with your family, watching that football game or basketball game, or taking that nap on a Sunday afternoon when you know you got the big test on Monday and you just don't really want to study, and you eat that other marshmallow instead of studying like you should. But I'd like to think that you're here today and your accomplishment is this because that you listened to a little bit of that, you thought about it, and you didn't eat the marshmallows. So today you get your marshmallow in the form of a graduation, a badge, and a 30-year career with the Greensboro Fire Department. Congratulations. We're very proud of you and glad that you have made this accomplishment and that you'll be with us for quite some time. So if you think about that, you think about the day the test ends, but it really doesn't end today. It's just one chapter of the test. For the next 30 years, you're going to experience these tests all through your career. You're going to have opportunities to make decisions. Do I accept something today, or do I put it off for a little bit longer for a greater reward at the end of the day? You'll be faced with that for your entire career. So I hope that you've learned a little bit in the last 21 weeks that, yes, it's worth putting off something for tomorrow so that I have a greater reward tomorrow. So thank you for that, and we look forward to you your career. So at this time, I'd like to read the award letter and present the award for the fire chief. So would Firefighter Gorson, if I didn't say it correctly, I apologize, come forward. On behalf of the officers and firefighters of the Greensboro Fire Department, I would like to congratulate you on your level of achievement over the past 21 weeks of recruit training. Your overall academic average of 97.79% places you at the top of the 69th recruit class for the Greensboro Fire Department and has earned you the Recruit Class Fire Chief's Award. As evidenced by your training file, you have consistently maintained a level of excellence deserving of this award. Your commitment to maintain the superior level of academic performance serves as an inspiration to those around you. Firefighter Ned Gorson, please accept my best wishes for your continued success and achievement in the Greensboro Fire Department.
At this time, Greensboro Fire Department and the training staff would like to recognize a few more individuals for their hard work and high performance. The officers and firefighters of the Greensboro Fire Department would like to congratulate you on your level of achievement over the past 21 weeks of training. Your overall level of practical skills and academic performance identifies you as an outstanding member and leader of the 69th recruit class. The training staff award is given in recognition of overall performance during a recruit training class. The recipient is selected by the training staff on the basis of outstanding leadership abilities, academic standing, and practical evolution. After reviewing evaluations throughout the class, your accomplishments are of no surprise. The training staff is pleased to inform you that you have been selected as the recipient of the 69th Recruit Class Training Staff Award. Firefighter Jeremy Wallace, please accept our best wishes for your continued success and achievement in the Greensboro Fire Department. This award recognizes the achievements of an individual who had the lowest average time for all firefighter abilities tests throughout the academy, which is our combat challenge test. That individual started the academy in superb shape and improved upon his skills in the 21 weeks of training. To receive the Cliff Oakley Fitness Award for your class is a great honor that says you stepped up to the challenge. Far below the time allowed for completing the course, with an overall average time of 2 minutes and 32 seconds. That's impressive. On behalf of the training staff and your fellow classmates of the 69th recruit class, we would like to congratulate you for your level of achievement over the past 21 weeks. Your achievements have earned you the 69th recruit class Cliff Oakley Fitness Award. Firefighter Christian McLean, please accept our best wishes for your continued success and achievement with the Greensboro Fire Department. And that average time is the best overall average we've ever had in the training academy. And I need to recognize one more person, because this person, him and Christian, had a thing going on. And it was very impressive to watch. They both tied for the best individual time at 2:16. We went and took all the average times. We averaged them up. And he was beat by 1 second. So Ben Bizzle, would you please stand? I'd like to recognize you and give you a hand. The last award. This award recognizes your abilities during the Recruit Academy to provide informal leadership to your classmates. It is a true honor to receive this recognition from your peers and speaks volumes to your integrity and your work ethic. On behalf of the training staff and your fellow members of the 69th recruit class, we would like to congratulate you as the recipient of the 69th Recruit Achievement Award. Firefighter Ned Gertson, please accept our best wishes for your continued success and achievement in the Greensboro Fire Department.
We will now receive comments from a representative of the class, and they will make a presentation also. Xander Ganey, come on up.
Is this thing working? Good morning. My name is Xander Ganey, and it is a privilege to speak on behalf of the 69th Recruit Academy. In opening of this, I would like to thank the Greensboro Fire Department Training Division for all the countless hours they spent preparing us for this journey we began on October 3rd. Also, I would like to thank the friends and families for attending today's ceremony and also for being our backbone on this long journey. If it weren't for you, we all wouldn't have made it. I know coming home tired and bruised after 8 to 9 hours of training a day, only to get a quick bite to eat and then to try to study a little more before you pass out due to exhaustion can be tough. So thanks for understanding. If you can't tell, I'm super nervous. For the 69th Fire Academy, our journey began October 3rd at 7 a.m. Even though the majority of us arrived at 6 a.m. due to us being scared and nervous for what the morning would consist of, nobody was late. We had all heard stories of the day they had called the gun range. By far, the majority of us would say this was the worst day we experienced. I don't have to elaborate because I'm sure your loved one informed you of it. But I'm proud to say that we all know which way is east in the gun range, and locking our cars is very important. We spent 21 weeks together learning how to become Greensboro firefighters. The first few weeks seemed to be the longest and most stressful as we tried to get into some sort of normal rhythm. The first few weeks were spent getting to know one another and how our personalities did and did not match up. On top of all the skills and techniques we learned on this journey, we also learned a few things we didn't enjoy so well. Those would include the maze, bin bailing, every Tuesday morning where we would endure on what seemed to be the longest 2 to 5 minutes of our lives. We learned that Captain Kennedy and Captain Hall could do push-ups for what seemed to be days, and Mr. Walker could make your whole body sore without using a single weight or piece of gym equipment. We also learned that Spangler can dry heave for 30 minutes and not get sick, and that Kevin does a great Kenny Chesney impression. But on a more serious note, we embarked on this journey 26 weeks ago, and it has been the most rewarding experience. We experienced mental and physical exhaustion as we prepared for tests and practicals. We missed out on quality family time and events with hopes of one day we would be here in this moment at graduation. Well, we made it. This is our moment. We earned this with blood, sweat, and tears. Even though this is the end of the rookie school journey, the new journey is just beginning. There are 4 words that the training staff live by. It's on their t-shirts, and they say it at least once a day. Work hard and be humble. They have imprinted that into our minds. Captain Jones also said a quote in the first weeks of training that we all need to keep close through these next 30 years. Don't let good luck reinforce bad habits. The people who live and work in this wonderful city now depend on us to do what we have been training to do for months. It's our job to continue to work hard and be humble and to represent the Greensboro Fire Department in the most professional way. So in closing, I would like to again thank the entire training staff consisting of Chief Gerald, Chief Vickery, Chief Combs, Captain Hall, Captain Jones, Captain Brownell, Captain Hutchinson, Captain Haney, and the PT instructors, Captain Kennedy, FEO Robertson, and retired FEO Jesse Walker, for pushing us to do our best and for putting up with us on a long 26 weeks and giving us the tools we needed to be successful out on the line. Also, I would like to thank the fellow firemen for taking time out of their days and away from their families to instill the endless knowledge that they may find trivial but is priceless to all of us. We promise to work hard and be humble and not to disappoint. So on behalf of the entire 69th Fire Academy, we say thank you, and we would like Chief Gerald to step forward and receive this plaque as a token of our appreciation.
Now's the time they get their badges. So ladies and gentlemen, if you would, hold your applause to the end. Recruits, stand up. If you will, present yourselves over here to this side. Those family members that are going to be pinning, come to my right. Benjamin Bailing, penned by Kathy Berry. Ben Bizzle, penned by Rihanna McEwen. Kevin Chesley, penned by Tia Jarrell. Xander Ganey, penned by Peggy Two. Ned Gertson, penned by Jamie Gardner. Blaine Gray, penned by Terry Gray. Kyle Haney, penned by Amy Efford. Christopher Hazeltine, penned by Hunter Hazeltine. Charlie Hawkins III, penned by Stephen Hawkins. Michael Haygood, penned by Derek Bowers. Allison Jones, penned by Cindy Doyle. Brittany King, penned by Jaden King. Christopher Marsh, penned by Jessica Marsh. Tyler Mathai, penned by Michelle Mathai. Bradley May, pinned by Bailey Hazel. Christian McLean, penned by Nancy McLean. Elizabeth Moniz, penned by Logan Moniz. Nathaniel Oliver, penned by Colleen Clark. Taylor Spangler, penned by Tim Spangler. Emily Speck, penned by David Speck. Thank you. Jeremy Wallace, penned by Lee Wallace. Ladies and gentlemen, let me be the first to congratulate and welcome the newest members of the Greensboro Fire Department, 69th class. All right, 69th class, stand up. You will now take your official oath. I state your name. You want to try that again? Do solemnly swear that I will support the Constitution of the United States. So help me God. I do further solemnly, sincerely swear that I will be faithful and bear true alliance to the state of North Carolina and to the constitutional powers and authorities which are or may be established for the government thereof, and that I will endeavor to support, maintain, and defend the Constitution of said state, not inconsistent with the Constitution of the United States, to the best of my knowledge and ability. So help me God. I do furtherly solemnly swear that I will well and truly execute the duties as a Greensboro firefighter according to the best of my skill and ability and according to law. So help me God. Captain Hall, would you please dismiss this class?
As soon as you're dismissed, if everyone would give us just a few minutes, we want the class to come on the stage and we're going to get a few photographs, give you a chance to take some as well. So, 69th Recruit Class, you are officially dismissed.